These scenes were taken from Chapter 1 of How to Steal a Dog by Brahma O'Connor.
The day Gabby decided to steal a dog was the same day her best friend, Luna Gregory, found out that Gloriana lived in a car.
Georgia had told her mama that Luna would find out sooner or later that seeing how she was so noisy and all, but mama had just rolled her eyes.
Just get up there to the bus stop, Georgina. Quit your whining. So that's what Georgina did. She stood up there at the bus stop pretending like she still lived in apartment 3B.
She pretended like she didn't have mustard on her shirt from the day before.
She pretended like she hadn't washed her hair in the bathroom at the taco station that was that very morning.
She pretended like her daddy hadn't just sawed off and left them with nothing but three rolls of quarter of mayonnaise and jar full of watered up dollar bills.
I guess I'm pretty good at pretending. Her brother Toby is not so good at pretending. When Mama told him to get on up to the bus stop and quit his whining, he cried and carried on like that baby he is.
What's wrong with Toby?
He has an earache.
Georgina saw Luna's eyes narrow and her lips squeezed together. She knew Luna's noisiness was about to irritate her.
Then how come your mama is taking him to go to school? Luna kept looking at Georgina's squeaking eyes. Georgina hopped and hoped she would just rush up to about Toby.
She did.
But then she went and turned her noisy self loose on me.
No offense, Georgina, but you're starting to look kind of
What if she wants me to come over? Or what if she looks in the window or something and finds out we don't live there anymore?
Mama just flapped her hands at Georgina and closed her eyes and to let her know how tired she was for working two jobs.
So every day Georgia imagines Luna peeking in the kitchen window of apartment 3B.
And then one day when they go off the school bus, Luna went and did the noisiest things I could imagine. She followed Georgina.
Georgia was trying to catch up with Toby because he had grabbed the car key and run on ahead of her, so she didn't even notice Luna sneaking along behind. She followed all the way past apartment 3B across the street and clear on the round back of Electus drugstore when the car was parked with the laundry hitting on a milk crate waiting for Georgina.
If there ever was a time when Georgina wished the earth would open up and swallow her whole, it was when she turned around and saw Luna looking at her and Toby in that car and everything.
It's just temporary. When Mama gets paid, we're moving into our new apartment. They both just stood there looking at their feet. Georgina could feel the distance between them grow until it seemed like Luna Gottfriede, who had been my friend forever, was standing clear on the other side of the universe.
I better go.
Promise you won't tell? I mean, not even your mama?
I promise.
Georgia curled her pinky finger and in the air and waited for Luna to give her the pinky promise, but Luna hesitated.
Georgina stomped her feet and gobbled her pinky at Luna. Finally, Luna cracked her and Georgina's they shook.
Luna left.
It was way past dark, then Georgina heard her mama's shoes click-clack and the asphalt.
Georgina sat up and looked out the window. Even in the dim light of the street light, she could see how her mama tired, sad look.
Part of Georgina wanted to stay put and just go on back to sleep and leave her be. But another part of her wanted to go out and have her say, which is what she did.
I hate this. I don't want to do this anymore.
Georgina pushed the car door shut softly and as not to wake her brother.
You got to do something. You got to find us a place to live. A real place, not a car.
I'm trying.
How are you trying?
Gina's mother tosses her purse through the car window into the front seat. I am okay, Georgina.
But how?
I'm working two jobs. What else do you want me to do?
Find us a place to live. This is all your fault.
Mama stormed
over and grabbed Georgina by her shoulders.
It takes money to get a place. I'm trying to save up, okay?
How much money do we need?
She looked up at the sky like the answer was written up there in the stars.
I don't know, Georgina, a lot, okay?
Like how much?
More than we got.
They both stood there in the dark and listened to the crickets for a person a lot.
We got to this.
Georgina's mother pulled the car into an alley beside Bill's auto parts. When she stunned the engine off, then were shuffled up in quietness.
Georgina shifted in her seat, turning every which way to get comfortable. She settled on her back bench with her feet pumped against the car door and stared out at the starry sky.
On the telephone pole right outside the car window was felt old sign.
The sign said they wanted $500 under the picture of a bog-eyed little dog with his tongue hanging out.
And then under that it said, have you seen him? My name is Miss Dizzy.
$500? Who in the world would pay $500 for that little old dog? Georgina stared out the window at the sign, thinking about Misty and wondering if there were other folks out there who would pay money for their lost dogs. I got a plan.
She closed her eyes and smiled to
me. She was gonna steal a dog.
Find out more about Georgina's plan and how to steal a dog by Barbara O'Connor.